Hello, this is Cristi. In this video, I would like to show you what is global animation in Camtasia. Animation is a great part of Camtasia, and global animation is a little thing that you may not notice as a beginner, or you may not even know it's there until you see this little icon in the interface. And a lot of time after I started using it, when I saw this feature there, I just ignored it because I wasn't sure what it was doing. Let me show you how useful this can be. So if I just add an object in Camtasia, I'm going to go to annotations and I'm going to use all and just add a little circle here and I'm going to animate this, right? So I'm going to make it larger, nothing special here. So on the timeline, I'm just going to go and add an animation to it. If I go to animations and then I add a custom animation to it, here we go down there. And let me zoom in a bit here, and here we go. So I'm going to move this object from left to right. Very simple animation, nothing special. Watch this. All good. Now, what is global animation? You may have noticed that if you select your object and you have an animation tool applied on it, you see this little icon on the top right corner, this little thing, animation editing mode. And as I said, I ignored it for a while. I didn't know what it was, but let me show you what it is. When you animate things in Camtasia, you know that you have two keyframes, basically. You have this arrow that signifies your animation, and it shows where the animation starts and where it ends. And it also moves the object from one point to another across the time of this animation. Now, as you move this before and after the playhead, you notice that the end of the animation becomes red. And if I move the object before this and I make a change, I am actually changing that keyframe. So if I move my playhead before the animation and move the object up here in the corner, now that keyframe is going to remember that the object is going to start from there instead of in the middle where it used to be. So now the object is still going to move, but it's going to start up there and move down to where it was. If I change the position or any other property of the object after the keyframe at the end of the animation, for example, I'm going to move it down here, then the animation is going to simply remember that that is where the object needs to end up. So if I go back, you see it, remember top left corner. And if I go to the bottom, bottom right corner. So that is how animation works. Now, global animation allows you to do one thing. If I say, I change my mind and I would like the circle to be smaller. And if I change the size of the circle before the animation starts, watch this, I'm making it smaller. Now the object is small in that particular point, but then as I go to the animation, it becomes large again because the ending of the animation remembers that the object is not only in the bottom right corner, but that it is also large. It remembers the size of the object as well as its position. And this also works with any other things you have applied to that object. Maybe you have an effect like a transparency or opacity or anything else. The animation will remember the state of that object in that point. So what do I need to do here? Now, one option would be for me to go to the end of the animation and say, oh, you know, I wanted this to be smaller, so change it in the same way. At the end of the animation, change the size of the object. Well, that is tedious and you're probably going to get it wrong because you don't know what size the object really is and you're going to just eyeball it and kind of, you know, mess it up. So now, of course, the object is small in both places. But let's say I change my mind again and I want to change the size of this object again. I want to make it larger again. Well, this is very tedious with animations in this way. And by the way, what if you have more animations? What if you have like 5 or 6 animations on the same object? Yeah? So that means you need to change the object about 12 times for 6 animations every time or before or after the keyframes, which can be very tedious, time consuming. So watch this. I'm doing another animation where I move the object here and then I move again another animation. Shift and A, by the way, adds a custom animation. Now it's in the middle. And then I do another animation where I go back to where I was. So across all of these animations, if I change my mind about the color or the size or the rotation or any other property of the object, I would have to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times to change this object. This is the problem that global animation resolves. If I turn on global animation, Camtasia is going to remember whatever changes I make and apply them to all the points of the animation. Well, as long as I don't change the position, because position actually is in my keyframes, right? So it's going to shift everything over. So watch this. I'm going to now turn on global animation. You may get a warning, by the way, with this when you turn it on. It's going to tell you, this Camtasia is going to tell you, are you sure you want to do this? Because as soon as you change something, it changes it everywhere. And you remember, as I said, when you edit one of the keyframes, it becomes red. Look in the timeline right now. You see all of the keyframes are red, which means any change I make is going to now be recorded in all those keyframes, wherever the object is. So I changed my mind. Let's say I want to make this circle larger. I'm going to make it quite large. And, you know, for good measure, let's change something else. I'm going to change the color. There it is. So now, because my global animation was on, all of these changes have been now recorded in all of those keyframes in the animation, except for the portions of the objects that I have actually changed in each one of them. So now I turn off global animation. Here we go. Now the keyframes are back to normal, but watch this. If I move now through my animation, you see that the size of the object is remembered and also the color, but the animation keeps playing. The object is still moving in those positions, right? But because it's much larger, it's now going outside of the screen. So I still retain the flexibility to now go in and say, oh, actually, I don't like the fact that this one goes out of screen, so I'm moving it in. So now because global animation is off, it remembers that particular change. There you go. You see it? I'm going here, fix this too, put it up in the screen, keep moving. I'm going to put this in the center of the screen. And then finally, the last one is fine. So again, I change my mind again. I say, well, I want it to be blue. Not a problem. Let's turn on the global animation and go and change to blue. There you go. Turn off global animation. And now my object is blue everywhere. If I change the color without global animation, let's say at the second animation here, I'm changing the color to purple, then that color is only purple there because I did not have global animation turned on. So to summarize, global animation allows you to change any property of an object after you've applied animations to it so that all those changes will apply in all of the keyframes of the animation. I hope this makes sense. It was a bit confusing for me at first, but if you haven't learned yet how animation works, check out this video in the screen right now, which shows you all of the basics of animation in Camtasia. And I show you a very nice example of how to build animation from scratch. And I explain why custom animation is really the only animation you need in Camtasia. There you go. Thank you for watching. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. And maybe I'll see you in my MediaMakers.club membership, where you can get all the courses for free, downloadable assets for Camtasia, and one-on-one sessions with me and Q&A sessions every week. Thank you very much for watching. See you on the next one.